Hi, this is Sean Broderick for Uncommon Wisdom Daily. The price of crude oil has dropped quite a bit lately, but how low can it go and how long will it keep going down? To answer those questions, it helps to look at all the factors that determine price movements. First, there's supply. A big reason for the decline is the fact that Saudi Arabia, Libya, and Iraq are all pumping flat out. Then there's global demand, especially from the emerging markets, where all the new demand is. You also have factors like geopolitical uncertainty, U.S. consumer demand, and the amount of oil in stockpiles. And sure enough, U.S. crude oil inventories recently reached their highest level in 22 years. And let's not forget speculators. If they drive oil prices on the way up, they must also drive them on the way down, right? So, all these factors play a role in determining the price of crude oil. But the single best indicator I've seen yet is one you may not have heard of. The Citigroup U.S. Economic Surprise Index. It measures economic news, good or bad, and charts whether it's a positive surprise or a negative surprise. As you can see, most of the recent economic news has surprised to the downside, pushing the Economic Surprise Index lower, and oil prices have gone down right along with it. Now, you might say this is just a coincidence and there's no real causal relationship here, but if you think about it, it makes sense that the worse the economic news is, the less oil that companies buy. So, back to the original question. How low will prices go? Well, if this trend of higher stockpiles and worse economic news continues, I think crude could test support around $65 a barrel. That's good news for U.S. consumers because it means lower gas prices. The decline in prices since April has put about an extra $112 billion in our pockets on an annualized basis. But don't forget the old saying, the best cure for low oil prices is low oil prices. The more prices fall, the more projects get shut in, and the less oil gets pumped. So, prices probably won't stay down for long unless there's a severe global recession. And if that happens, we'll have more to worry about than the prices we pay at the pump. I'm Sean Broderick for Uncommon Wisdom Daily. Thanks for watching.